Your exclusive home for Alabama gymnastics is right here, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7.
Good evening to you all in Tuscaloosa, around the great state of Alabama, and around the country. Listen to us live on the TuneIn Radio app. I would like to welcome you via these airwaves to the Coleman Coliseum here in Tuscaloosa on the campus of the University of Alabama with my partner, as always, Lisa Davis. Lisa, how you doing tonight?
Doing great tonight. Ready to roll with the Tide, hopefully, over the Florida Gators.
Jan Davis is going to be joining us soon. She's the third member of our broadcasting team, and she's also a live blogger for the Crimson Tide. All right, this Tide team, they have a Friday's date with a team that needs no introduction. They're proving their discipline, and they're currently the queen of college gymnastics. That is the Florida Gators. The card defending national champion team from Gainesville currently holds the number one ranking in all their land. Alabama will have to pull out all the stops this evening to best this talented Florida squad. Lisa, what makes this Florida Gator team so dangerous?
Well, what's interesting is you said in your opening was the Florida Gators are co-champions, and this week they're co-tied for number one.
That's funny, isn't it?
Oklahoma. So those two teams right now are competing at the highest level in college gymnastics. Where Alabama is at number seven this week, falling back because of the loss at Arkansas and the lower score they had on the road. So what about Florida? Well, this is a team that graduated some talent, but boy, they got some talent in. Freshman Alec McMurtry and Kennedy Baker are two freshmen that are all-around gymnasts. They pretty much filled in the gap. They are loaded from top to bottom, extremely talented. They will go toe-to-toe with Alabama, and it's going to be a prize fight tonight. Whoever blinks is going to be looking through the glass on the outside.
This is Frazier Ali without question. The Tide are coming off a disappointing performance last week, especially on the balance team. They lost to a young yet hungry, talented Arkansas team. What adjustments has Coach Dana Duckworth made when it comes to the Pearson balance team?
Well, balance team, of course, has a lot of pride when it comes to Coach Dana Duckworth. She's a two-time national champion for the Crimson Tide as an athlete, and she's been the assistant coach, choreographing the routines on that through the years, and then, of course, now head coach. So she was extremely disappointed with their performance.
Yep.
But Alabama, on three events, competed spectacularly last week on the road, but you got to have that fourth event. It counts.
Yep.
And unfortunately, they just let their mental game get away from them.
Especially on the road, you can't do that.
You cannot do that because once Arkansas smelled blood in the water, it was unfortunately, three gymnasts. That is so rare for, two to come off, much less, and count one, much less two. So an abnormality that just happened on the road. I know they went back into the gym, practiced hard on the mental aspect of balancing as well as all the four events. And again, it goes back to you've got to compete for four events, four rotations, four quarters in football. You can't beat up a team for three quarters and expect, to have a letdown.
Gotta keep your foot on the gas.
Have to keep that energy level high. And I think that's what she, saw, maybe a letdown of energy in that.
Well, despite that, it's not all negative for the Tide. Entering this meet with one of its top rivals, Alabama is number one nationally ranked on the floor and second on the vault. They've really showed their strength in those two aspects of the gymnastics meet. The uneven bars rank has slipped to 19, yet not terrible, and now the Tide falls to 21 on the balance beam, following three nasty falls last week versus the Razorback. But the Tide are looking to improve on both the bars and the beam. And Lisa, they will need a near flawless performance tonight to defeat a Florida team that is coming into Coleman red hot with victories against Ball State and fellow SEC rival Auburn.
They will. It will have to be a spectacular performance on all four events. You cannot have a mistake. You will not be able to count a mistake tonight. Those teams are just too talented, and one, again, you give up any little edge to Florida and they're going to take it because they're loaded on all four events. They don't have a weakness. And where Alabama has a weakness right now, at the beginning of the season we thought it was going to be an even ball.
Right
now, it is a problem.
It's a week-by-week process.
It is. And you know, until, and hopefully they figured out the problem. But all Alabama has to do is just believe in themselves, remember their training all fall and all summer long, that what got them here tonight. They've got the gymnastics, they've got the skills, they just got to get out there and perform it under pressure.
Florida's going to be missing three-time All-American Bridget Sloan. Lisa, talk her absence. How big will that be for the Gators?
It's a big loss for them, but again, talking about how deep they are on all four events, they're really not missing her because they scored the 197 last week against Auburn at home, and they've got the talented freshmen that went in and took her place on four of it. Kennedy Baker, Alex McMurtry, she scored a 10 overall. Yeah. The week before that, Bridget Sloan has scored the 10 on ball at the opening meet of the season. So Alex picked her up. Yeah, exactly. So you've got two gymnasts that can seriously go all around and score big time for the Florida Gators.
This place is going to be nearly filled to capacity, maybe close to a sellout here at the University of Alabama in Coleman Coliseum. The Tide's last loss in this building, 2009 versus LSU. Lisa, what can you tell us about that meet?
Wow, that was an unexpected loss. Alabama, again, competing so well, you know, throughout the night, but they ran into some problems on balance beam and bars, and unfortunately lost a very close one to LSU. That's been a long time. They built an impressive home streak in Coleman Coliseum. They need this crowd to pack out this stadium to give them support nonstop from the minute the first ball goes to the last exercise. We need to hear this Tide Nation behind these gymnasts.
Dana Duckworth and her team are looking to keep this six-year home winning streak alive. We're going to take a quick break here on the pregame show. You're listening to 90.7 FM The Castle, your exclusive station for the home call of every Alabama gymnastics meet.
I'm Ashley Priest, and you're listening to the exclusive home of Alabama Gymnastics 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7!
Set up an ID. And you, her boyfriend. You were the driver?
Yes, doctor, but
I didn't mean to hurt her. I only had a few drinks. I was just buzzed.
Just buzzed? Oh, then your girlfriend is fine.
Hey, sweetie. I feel great.
She's really okay?
What, are you kidding? No. Not really. Nurse, get me a suture kit. Stat.
Buzzed driving. Maybe you should stop acting like it's no big deal. Buzzed driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Transportation and the Ad Council.
Whether I'm training for a marathon, kickboxing, or lifting, I train to add muscle and build my inner strength. I'm always working to increase my reps and beat my own best time. I am proud that I was born this way, driven. That's why I serve in the United States Coast Guard. You can find me on a Coast Guard cutter, along with my shipmates, who are a lot like me, driven and committed to our country and the safety of our citizens. We collect maritime intelligence. We catch drug smugglers approaching our coasts. And we're ready to respond to emergency calls from vessels in distress. 24/7, no matter our mission, we expect the very best from each other. We were born for this. We were born for the Coast Guard.
Were you born ready for the Coast Guard? Learn more at GoCoastGuard.com.
Sponsored by the United States Coast Guard in cooperation with the Alabama Broadcasters Association and the station.
Odds of this Alaskan-born pitcher being selected to the Major League Baseball All-Star Game 6 times? 1 in 48 million. The odds of this fast-balling philanthropist winning the World Series 3 times? 1 in 3 million. The odds of this man having a child diagnosed with autism? 1 in 110. Hi, I'm Kurt Schilling. Learn the signs of autism at autismspeaks.org. Brought to you by Autism Speaks and the Ad Council. Major League Baseball trademarks used with permission.
I'm Marissa Gutierrez, and you're listening to the exclusive home of Alabama Gymnastics, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7.
We are back at Coleman Coliseum on Military Appreciation Night, and we are ready to go for the number one ranked team in all the land. The Florida Gators travel here to Tuscaloosa to take on the number 7 Alabama Crimson Tide. We have all these numbers on Florida, at least, so I'm going to get everybody to top 10. Currently, as it stands, Florida and Oklahoma, not only did they tie to the biggest prize in college gymnastics last year, they are tied currently at the top of the standings, both averaging a 197.063. Followed by those two in the first place, you have LSU in third, another SEC foe. Michigan and the Wolverines stand at fourth, tied with the Utah Utes. At sixth, you got the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Alabama comes in at 7. At 8 is UCLA. 9 cracking the top 10 for the first time this year is the Oregon State Beavers from the Pac-12. And rounding off the top 10 is Georgia at 10, following a defeat at the hands of Denver last week up there in the Rocky Mountains. Lisa, give us some matchups in the top 10.
All right, we're talking about last week, before this week, Number one Gators defeated Auburn 197-2 to 195-65. Oklahoma took down Minnesota 196.5 to 194.475. The Bayou Bengals of LSU defeated Kentucky Wildcats 195.6. And Arizona State in a climbing 194-4. Michigan defeated Ohio State in a Big Ten rivalry in West Virginia 196.975 to 195.825, 194.175. Utah defeated Southern Utah 195.5. Boise State 194.525 and UC Davis 193.95 in a quad meet. The Utes scored a 196.675 in that victory. The Cornhuskers took down Penn State 197.125, their highest score of the season. Penn State came in at 196.825. We saw it last week. The Crimson Tide fell to the Arkansas Razorbacks 196.175 to 196.325. The Bruins of UCLA defeated Arizona in a Pac-12 showdown 195.975 to 195.3. Oregon State 195.975 took down Iowa State, and Southeast Missouri 195.95 to 193.3. And the number 10 Georgia Gym Dog 195.8 defeated Missouri 195.225 in a very close SEC match.
When you look just outside of the top 10, you got some in the 11, 12, and 13 spots, Illinois, Champaign, Arkansas, Penn State, and followed by that is number 14, Kentucky. Lisa, we'll be in Lexington next week. Do you see a team in there that's poised to break the top 10?
Well, we saw Illinois last week that were in the top 10 after the first week. They just moved back to number 11. So that's a team they will need to keep an eye on to see how well they do over the season. And then also, you talked about Denver taking down Georgia on a Monday meet. Denver's a program that has been in and out of the top 10, top 15 over the years, too. But in action tonight, John, Florida, of course, here at Alabama, Oklahoma hosting Texas women in Southeast Missouri, LSU hosting Missouri, Utah hosts UCLA, Nebraska at Rutgers with Southern Connecticut, Georgia hosting Kentucky, Michigan hosting Illinois. Will it be interesting to see the come out of that meet? Oregon State at Stanford. And that is your top 10, where they are competing tonight and this weekend.
Lisa, a question that everyone has at home. When it comes to the Final Six, the Super Six, as they call it, is there the conference tournaments, or is there automatic qualifiers, or is it just the top six scores when it comes to the end?
Now, when you're talking about qualifying, we have an SEC championship, Pac-12 championship. Those are considered, whoever's hosting, those will be used as road scores, could help your RQS regional qualifying score. School, which will have you seeded into six regions across the country. And for those, only two teams out of all six will advance to the NCAA championship. You will have 12 teams reseeded at the NCAA, and then those teams will be dropped down to six.
The six compete for the national championship.
We just received the official NCAA Women's Gymnastics score sheet, and we have the competitors on the vault and the uneven bars for Alabama. It's going to be in order: Keely McNear, Max Brayman, Carly Sims, Caitlin Clark, Lauren Beers, and senior captain Kayla Williams rounding out the vaulting crew. And on the uneven bars for the Georgia Bulldogs, you'll have Kirsten Wang, Rachel Spicer, Bridget Caquato, Kennedy Baker, Keetra Hunter, and Alex McMurtry. We're going to take a break here on the Alabama Women's Gymnastics Radio Network, 90.7 The Capstone.
I'm Joan Stack-Eaton, and you're listening to the exclusive home of Alabama Gymnastics, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7!
We'll be right back. this week's episode, Danger at the Old Well.
Last one to the old well to rot me! Ha! I win! Whoa! Ah! Sassy! Johnny fell down the well!
I'm wet!
What, Sassy? You know where Mr. Gunderson keeps his rope? Go get it, girl! What? You'd rather use this time to set people straight about shelter pet adoption?
I'm cold!
People shouldn't be afraid to adopt from a shelter? Because shelter pets are screened for sound health and temperament?
I'm wet and cold!
Sassy, what about Johnny? What? Let Johnny sit in the well until he learns to be more self-reliant? Sassy!
What'd he say?
Sassy is brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org. Remember, adopt!
NFL quarterback for the New Orleans Saints, here with Bugs Bunny to remind you to get moving every day.
Because when you get moving an hour a day,
you fuel your body and your mind.
So what do you like to throw around the football like Drew?
Skateboard, ride a bike, or dance in your room.
Just move it the old way.
And be a player.
Get up and play an hour a day, Doc. Check out how to be a player at letsmove.gov.
Head online to get tips on great ways to get moving every day.
At letsmove.gov. A message from the Ad Council and HHS.
I'm Ashley Sledge, and you're listening to the exclusive home of Alabama Gymnastics, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7.
Welcome back to Coleman College, Dean of the University of Alabama. This is Alabama Women's Gymnastics on your only station for the home call of the game, 90.7 FM The Capstone. I'm here with my broadcast partner, Lisa Davis, as the Tide are ready to come out. And this crowd is about to jump, Lisa. This crowd has to be a huge factor tonight. If not for, I don't know, swaying some judges' opinions or it comes to firing up the ladies. But absolutely, after being in Arkansas with you last week, we take for granted this crowd we have here in Coleman.
You cannot replace what a crowd, 15,000, if we can get a patch in tonight, John, can do to bring your performance to another level.
And here come the Crimson Tide. Big Al leading the way right through the smoke and mirrors.
And what I love, John, is technology has come to Coleman College. Everybody in the arena has their smartphones lit.
Yeah, everyone's got the flash on their phone. It's actually an unbelievable scene here in Coleman College. Theatrics and all, Alabama knows what they must do tonight. They are going against the champ. And when you swing at the queen, you best not miss. That's what they say out there on the street. And so Alabama is going to need a miraculous performance. And Lisa, I have to ask you, losing to Arkansas last week, I don't want to say it's a good thing because it's never good to lose, but does it hone in some of the focus that they needed for this week?
I think so. I think it can bring, especially your leaders like Kayla Williams and Kayla Clark, Laura Lee Frost, your senior,
yep,
Hunter Dennis. I think it can kind of motivate them to say, you know, we need to really, really get this team ourselves first and then our team around us. We need to get into that Bama bubble, and we need to compete with authority, with confidence, and we need to show not only ourselves and our coaches, but our fans that we have got this, and the Bean is not going to own us. We're going to own the Bean.
And right now, a quick shout-out to the Alabama women's cheerleading team that currently won a national championship last week. Lisa, did you catch any of that?
Absolutely. Can't wait to see it when they show the championships on air. I know it's tape delayed,
yep,
but congratulations to both the co-ed varsity Alabama cheerleading squad and the all-girl. The first time in the country a team has gone, two teams winning the national championships in cheerleading. So congratulations. A big part of Crimson Tide athletics on basketball, football, gymnastics, every sport.
And that's
a cheerleader, I love it.
Former cheerleader, sometimes it moves over to gymnastics. And we're going to have gymnastics for you following this play. Thank you for listening to the Alabama pregame show here on 90.7 FM The Capstone. When we come back, It's showtime, ladies and gentlemen, again. You're listening to the Capstone.
Hey, I'm Paul Fondo, my favorite station in the world, 90.7, the Capstone.
Scared. It's kind of like an elephant is on my chest.
I feel like I'm choking.
Sometimes my parents have to take me to the hospital.
You know how to react to their asthma attacks. Here's how to prevent them. Call 1-866-NO-ATTACKS. Visit www.noattacks.org or call your doctor. Because even one attack is one too many.
I feel like a fish with no water.
Brought to you by the EPA and the Ad Council.
I'll never forget that moment.
As long as I live.
My first call ever as a member of the National Guard.
When we got to the armory, they briefed us on the wildfires. They were getting dangerously close to homes.
Helicopters were going out to drop water on the fires.
Guys in the unit were preparing for firefighting with local fire crews.
At that moment, I got my first taste of just how important the Guard is to my community.
See how the Guard can be an important part of your life at NationalGuard.com.
Sponsored by the Alabama National Guard, aired by the Alabama Broadcasters Association and this station.
Your exclusive home for Alabama gymnastics is right here, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7.
We are back at Coleman Coliseum on the campus of the University of Alabama, where the 7th-ranked Crimson Tide take on the number one Florida Gators in a heavyweight prize fight when it comes to gymnastics standards. We have the lineups ready to go. Going to be a 4 minute puck stroller in the 30 second warm-up. Alabama is going to go to the vault with Kiwi McNair. She usually starts it off with a tie, if not Katie Bailey. Bailey is going to perform third. She'll compete third just behind Mackenzie Brennan. Then it's going to be seniors Caitlin Clark, junior Lauren Deers, and round it off with senior captain Kayla Williams. For the Florida Gators on the bar, here is Kennedy Baker, Claire Boyce, Bianca Dancos, Jean Biastito, Bridget Chiquesto, Keisha Hunter, and Alex McMurtry. On the bars for Alabama, on the second rotation, you'll have Mac Brennan, Keely McNear, Katie Bailey, Asia Sims, Amanda Cheddar, and Lauren Beers. And for the Florida Gators on the vault, you'll get Kristen Lang, Rachel Spicer, Bridget Cicato, Kennedy Baker, Keitra Hunter, and Alex McMurtry. On the third rotation for the Alex team, where Alabama must improve this week, they will send out Kayla Williams, Katie Bailey, Keely McNear, Lauren Beers, Caitlin Clark, and Asia Sims. Lisa, are you surprised to not see Kayla Williams on that rotation?
Actually, you're seeing her being moved from the final sixth position cleanup to the start.
And oh, there she is. Completely shut my screen.
Kayla has traditionally, in her career, started the beam off of the Crimson Tide. I think that's where she is the most comfortable. She gets it over with. She sets the table. She is a calm competitor. And I just think that's more natural for her to start
and finish.
Yes.
It's a psychological game.
Yes, and I think that's where her strength is going to come in, because she's the leader of this team, and she wants to lead first off.
Absolutely. She wants to set the edge for Alabama. That's Alabama on the beam. On the floor for Florida, the following will be Claire Boyce, Erica Fassbender, Kirsten Wang, Kennedy Baker, Tiesa Hunter, and Bridget Cicato. And on the final fourth rotation on the floor, Alabama will send out Katie Bailey, Asia Sims, Carly Sims, Caitlin Clark, Lauren Deers, and Laura Lee Frost, the senior, will round out Alabama on the floor. And on the beam for the Florida Gators, they will send out Kennedy Baker, Rachel Spicer, Alex McMurtry, Claire Boyce, Erica Fassbender, and Keisha Hunter. That is Florida on the beam. Those are the four quarters of Alabama and Florida. We're about ready to start in 2 minutes. And we are just being joined by Jan Davis. She is the third member of our broadcasting team and live blogger. She will join us momentarily. Lisa, do you expect Alabama to get up to a hot start right now?
Hope so, and it'll begin with Keely McNair, and Keely really looks focused in the long warm-ups, really going for that stick on her Yurchenko foot. She will set the stage, and the emotion and how big the crowd's going to come into it if she nails that opening Yurchenko foot for the Crimson Tide.
With a team as talented as Florida, do you expect Alabama and Coach Taylor Duckworth to put in some more difficult gymnastics to try to up the scores? Are they going to try to play it as usual, try to do their thing and compete to their level?
Well, we already saw her up the ante last week at Arkansas with two new dismounts. We saw Katie Bailey bring in her full-out dismount, and we saw Carly Tim do her top pull in, and they did fantastic at Arkansas on the road with those two dismounts. We expect to see them again tonight. As for adding more difficulty, we're going to be looking at the floor exercise.
Yep.
Will she allow Katie Bailey to do her Arabian tonight?
Absolutely. And we were saying earlier, don't be surprised if you see a 10-0. These are some fantastic gymnastics, and these are two of the best teams in the entire nation. Not to mention a fierce rivalry. Lisa, before we start, under 50 seconds, just talk to this rivalry and its history, because you've seen it more than anyone.
And it's actually a young rivalry that has been building over the last 5 years. Since Florida really soared up into the nation's top spot. Being back-to-back national championships, before that it was Alabama that was the back-to-back national champion.
Absolutely.
So it's a natural rivalry that has been building. We've seen it across the sports. Florida has a tremendous basketball team. Yeah, everybody was watching them win national championships. And then the Gator gymnastics team won also. We see it across in softball, too, that big rivalry between Florida and Alabama.
Jeremy Foley, without question, has to be one of the best athletic directors in all the nation. Football, basketball, gymnastics, softball, Florida brings it at almost everything.
They do, but we kind of like our guys here, too. Alabama doesn't cut any slack when it comes to
Absolutely.
Putting the best athletes we can out on the floor for any sport.
Absolutely. Of course, Bill Battle taking over over for the late great Mal Moore. He's done a fantastic job.
And we have seen a spotting tonight of Bill Battle in the arena. So glad to see him supporting Crimson Tide Gymnastics.
Absolutely. And it's going to be ready to go. Leading off for Alabama, you're going to get Keely McNair now. She needs to get off to a strong start for the Crimson Tide.
And if you're wondering about the fashion report and what everybody's wearing tonight, it's the Gators in that Gator blue torso, solid Leo, one mesh blue sleeve, one mesh white sleeve. Alabama in their crimson solid Leo with a super silver script A and dead center in the chest crystallized. Alabama, Florida, the blue versus the red.
Here we go. As it's meant to be, Alabama and Florida ready to write a new chapter into their storied college gymnastics rivalry.
And again, SEC TV tonight bringing you this meet. We want to see more Crimson Tide fans inside Cone in the Coliseum. Still room for y'all to come in.
Absolutely.
And support the Alabama Gym Tide.
As you look around, it is pretty much filling, so I wouldn't say to capacity. But nonetheless,
it's
fantastic. It's funny, before the lights go off, it's not as though the lights go off, and then all of a sudden this place is nearly filled. And now, trying to make this place very loud is Keely McNair. She is on the vault.
She is down the runway. Your chinko full in the air, chest down, really going for that stick, but her chest was down on landing, and she took a little step forward. So two significant deductions in that first vault.
McNair gets a high five from coaches Bill Lorenz and Brian Rochilla. And now for the Florida Gators, it's Kennedy Baker on the bars.
Talented freshman. She can go all around for the Gators, and she will tonight for them.
Here comes Baker, bending to the bars. She's going to use the springboard to get up there.
She jumps to grab that high bar. Chip test to handstand. Toe-on release to Kotchev, that's known as a Ray release. Kip Kaz right back up to that handstand position. Will bear to the handstand position on low bar. Straddle toe shoot from low bar to high bar. Kip Kaz handstand, beautiful positions on these handstands. Toe-on half turn, double front dismount, and just a tiny little hop backwards on the landing.
Florida showing how dominant they can be, setting the pace right there with a very good routine from freshman Kennedy Baker. Now for Alabama, it's going to be Mackenzie Brannon.
Mac Brannon has been doing extremely well vaulting for the Crimson Tide. She's got beautiful form, long legs, but the coaches want a stick landing from her tonight.
Absolutely. Coach Bill Lorenz, a fixture on the vault, has been working with the Crimson Tide all week to keep this excellent vault number up because they've been phenomenal all year. And here comes Mac Brannon.
Looking down the runway, full twist in the air. Beautiful leg, beautiful position, but it's just a tiny little, what we call a bunny hop backwards.
A very good routine from Brannon as the crowd is loving it. They got all the shakers here in Military Appreciation Week. A nice section for the ROTC students right behind the floor and close to the vault. And now for the Florida Gators, you're going to get Claire Boyce.
Claire Boyce is a sophomore for the Gators. She'll be seeing her a lot tonight.
The tallest gymnast on the team. She stands at 5'6" from Arlington, Texas.
She will glide kick to handstand on the low bar. Toe on to handstand. Shaposhnikova release from low bar to high bar. And will bail back to the handstand position from high bar to low bar. Still circle with the feet. Will jump from low bar to high bar. Kick as handstand. Snip short. Giant. Giant swing, nice toe point in the air, double layout dismount, and kind of almost sticks it, but then decides to, as she salutes the judges, to walk backwards before a quick salute.
Some scores are in for the Crimson Tide. Keely McNair has scored a 9.825 following her vault routine. And for the, just another one, Mackenzie Brannon. Mac Brannon's score comes in at 9.900, so a solid start for the Crimson Tide. One for Florida, Kennedy Baker scored a 9.800 flat. And now for the Gators, for the Crimson Tide, you're going to see Katie Bailey, who is one of the strongest gymnasts, at least I have seen.
And Katie brings a different vault. It's known as an Arabian half or a Haristikava. Very, very beautiful height on that vault, but one step forward. It's a blind landing because she will be facing away from the vault as she lands. But the beautiful body form in the air, tremendous height and distance for Katie, but the one step on the landing for the deduction.
She gets some love from her Alabama teammates, still waiting for the score for boys. And now for Florida, help me with this name, Lisa. We have Bianca Dankos.
Giambattista.
Giambattista.
And she is one of their high-scoring uneven ball workers for the Gators. She can bring a 9.975 and flirt with the 10.
DDG is on the bar.
Tip-cast handstand on the low bar. Toe on handstand. Shaposhnikova from low bar to high bar. And we'll bail back to the handstand position on low bar. Soul circle with the feet will jump from low bar to high bar. Tip-cast right up to that handstand over arch. Manages to get it back on track. Giant swing. Double layout in the air.
Wow.
And a tiny little hop backwards. Not her best. We saw last week her get like a 9.95, 9.925. I'll have to check my SEC report. But super high, 2 weeks in a row, she's really been scoring for the Florida Gators.
Well, a lower score for the Gators. Claire Boyce comes in with a score of 9.725, which is lower than her teammate Baker, who scored a 9.800. For Alabama, Katie Bailey scores in, and it is a good one, 9.875. Alabama has been excellent as far on the vault, but this is nothing new. They've been excellent on the vault all year, and now it's going to be time for senior All-American captain, Caitlin Clark.
And what the coaches want is to now start seeing the big six from their back three gymnasts. Caitlin down the runway, full twist in the air.
Yeah.
She does it.
She's absolutely fixed it, and she knows it. Absolute jubilation. She's giving love to her coaches. Alabama teammates come all the way down the vault to greet her. She is enjoying this. My goodness, and the crowd is giving it to her.
Full twist in the air, beautiful height and distance always from Caitlin. And then the landing, she did not move, but feet were a bit apart. Let's see what the judges give her.
Oh, doggy, we got a 10. Bang.
And a 9.95.
Uh-oh, and a 9.95. I forgot that darn average they do.
That's right. 9.975 is still spectacular for Caitlin, and where they took off with the feet being slightly apart on the landing.
One of these days we're going to get a 10 here. If not right now, it might be in the second vault. Now for the Florida Gators, you're going to get Bridget Cacquato.
And Bridget will mount with a jump to the high bar, tip cast right up to the handstand position. Ray release, kind of clipped her wrist, but kept her momentum going. No problems there. Toe onto handstand. Beautiful form with these handstands. We're back to the handstand position on low bar. Soul circle with the feet. We'll jump from low bar to high bar. Tip cast handstand. Giant. Second giant, and she will release for a double layout. Beautiful form in the air. Legs and body straight, but a little movement backwards on the landing.
Yep. Some scores have also come in. Bianca Dankos has...
Giambattista.
Giambattista. At least you're going to have to remind me this all night, because I am flat out. That is a tongue twister from a person from the Northeast. And she comes in with a score of 9.750. So, again, not a bad score by any means, but not the highest. Caitlin Clark receives a final of 9.975. And now it's time for the junior All-American, Lauren Beers. Lauren's going to try to add to this impressive Alabama vault.
It is one fearsome lineup when you look at it on paper.
And Beers wants to completely mimic her teammate Caitlin Clark on the landing of this. Yurchenko full in the air, and she's leaning a little forward. She fell for it, but a tiny little movement forward with the foot. She actually came in a little tight in the body, so judges can take off for that. And then the slight foot movement forward to check the landing.
Absolutely.
You can see her gritting her teeth, trying with everything in her not to move.
Now for Florida, it's time for Keetra Hunter. Keetra Hunter will attempt the uneven bars, and she's a good one, Lisa.
Keetra Hunter, All-American, big part of those two back-to-back NCAA championships for the Gators.
Senior from Frederick, Maryland.
She will mount with the high bar, tip cast handstand. Free hip circle to Kachev. Tip cast handstand. Toe on handstand. Beautiful form on these handstands. Back to the handstand position on low bar. She's fighting that momentum of trying to arch over, but gets it back into gear with a straddle toe shoot to handstand on high bar. Giant tuck full in, and then a step forward. Her chest was down. She held that tuck a little bit.
Yep.
Caused her to take just movement forward, But again, a lot of difficulty and beautiful handstand positions in that ball routine for Teacher Hunter.
Absolutely. Of course, the judges are going to take that into effect, but there hasn't been one score thus far for Florida that's been truly outstanding.
What this is telling me is the judges tonight on the uneven bars, they are really, really looking for keyed out positions, and they're not going to give you anything. You're going to have to earn everything, and Alabama needs to pay attention to that.
And now a big hand for Kayla Williams. She's the cleanup hitter for Alabama coming in at the sixth spot.
And Kayla will be throwing the more difficult ball tonight. She pared down last week at Arkansas, the Yachinko full, tonight. And she's actually interrupted her run down the vault. So long as she doesn't touch the vault, she has a second chance to go back. Her timing was off.
Okay.
So she, by bailing off the runway and not touching the equipment, she has a chance for a do-over.
I have never seen that happen
in 4 years with Taylor Williams.
I haven't seen that happen.
Never happened.
That's just a timing thing.
That's a timing issue. She had the run, but she didn't see where her hand placement, which is critical with the Yurchenko, it was off, so she did the safe thing.
Okay, good.
So she's now going back, getting her head together.
Is that first thing is a fault? Because you do that as many times as you know.
She has one more. That's it.
Okay. Getting a huge
together
right
now.
Breathing heavily is Kayla Williams.
Wow.
1.5 kicks. A little deep knee bend and hop backwards, but she mustered through it. That took a big gut to throw that big vault when her timing was off on the first attempt and to be able to pull that around. Beautiful frame in the air, but the deep knee bend. Not super, but she bent the knees to land it, and then the little hop backwards, so there will be deductions for that. But bravo, Taylor Williams.
From Huntington, West Virginia, where she attended the Cincinnati Gymnastics Academy, has been the undisputed vocal leader for Alabama, and now Florida's on the uneven bars.
Freshman McMurtry, tip cast handstand on the high bar, toe on handstand, giant full turn. And then we'll bail to the handstand position on low bar, straddle toe shoot from low bar to high bar, tip cast handstand, a little bit short, giant swing, and she has a tuck full in and a little hop forward on that.
Some scores have come in for both Alabama and Florida. We're going to run them down to show you them all. For Alabama, Keely McNair finishes with a 9.825. Mac Brennan with a 9.900. Katie Bailey comes in with a 9.875. Caitlin Clark with the most impressive score of the evening, 9.975. Lauren Deers with a 9.875. And Kayla Williams will match her junior teammate with a 9.875. Alabama finishes with a total of 49.500. Another impressive run on the vault. Florida on the bars, Kennedy Baker with 9.800, Claire Boyce with a 9.725, Bianca Danko's Jim Lorette, you're going to have to do this all night, comes in with a 9.750, Bridget Caquato with a 9.775, Deirdre Hunter with a 9.800, and Alex McMurtry, score has yet to come in,
9.825,
those are the scores. For Alabama and Florida, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back for the second quarter of play. Alabama's going to be on the bars. Florida's going to be on the vault. You're listening to the Capstone.
I'm Marissa Gutierrez, and you're listening to the exclusive home of Alabama Gymnastics, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7.
Thank you.
entire piece of music is played with only two instruments, a right hand and a left hand. Hands can do incredible things, but nothing compares to using them to help save a life with hands-only CPR. If an adult suddenly collapses, call 911, then push hard and fast in the center of their chest until help arrives. Hands-only CPR is recommended by the American Heart Association, and it's incredibly easy and effective. For more information on hands-only CPR and to make your own hand symphony track, visit handsonlycpr.org today. The power to help save a life is in your hands. A message from the American Heart Association and the Ad Council.
This week's episode, Trouble on Rock Hill.
Ain't nothing like running up and down Rock Hill.
Hey, let's move this rock.
Whoa! Sassy, Johnny stuck under that rock. Yeah, girl, go tell Mr. Gunderson to bring his truck. You'll tell him, but only after you dispel a stereotype associated with shelter pets? People think shelter pets come with lots of initial veterinary costs?
It's dusty under here.
But in reality, most shelter pets have been vaccinated, neutered, and microchipped in case they get lost.
My pants ripped.
Sassy, Johnny needs help. What Johnny really needs is more discipline and better parental supervision. You use big words, Sassy.
Still under the rock.
Sassy is brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org. Remember, adopt.
I'm Ashley Sledge, and you're listening to the exclusive home of Alabama Gymnastics, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7.
Welcome back to Coleman Coliseum here on Military Appreciation Night. I want to thank you for tuning in to listening to us here on The Capstone, 90.7 FM. Some scores following Alex McMurtry's score came in at 9.825, as Lisa said earlier. So after the first quarter of play, Alabama leading 49.500 to Florida's 48.950. And Lisa, you said this judging is going to be quite difficult when it comes to the uneven bars.
Listen, because Florida is one of the best uneven bar teams in the country.
And they have to score.
Beautiful handstands now. They have some overarching and some transition problems. Nothing major, but small little stuff that I think the judges are really, really critiquing these routines. And Alabama better pay attention to that, and they better top out those forms.
Absolutely. As you look to the second quarter of play now, we'll run by it real quick for Florida. Actually, we're not going to have time to run through it all. So Florida attempting the first is going to be Kristen Wang. Kristen Wang is a senior from Moment, Colorado, where she attended Colorado Aerial Gym Academy.
Monument.
Monument. Monument, monument.
I have my glasses on.
You do. Here comes Wang.
Kirsten is down the runway. The first vaulter for the Florida Gators. Your Chinko full twist and a little hop sideways. Tiny hop, but a good vault to start the Gators.
Wow, not too shabby for Florida. And, of course, with our friends at the SEC Network Live here, time is always an issue. We're going to go very quick. No exhibition gymnast. No exhibition gymnast tonight. So for Alabama, leading off, it's going to be Mack Brennan.
And Mack Brennan had a great ball routine last week. She really showed a lot of fortitude by got some overarching and some handstand positions and really fought to stay on the bars at Arkansas and keep her score in the team lineup. So Mack will mount with the straddle vault over the low bar to grab the high bar, tip test handstand. Toe on half. She will throw a straddle Jaeger, nicely caught, tip cast handstand. Toe on handstand, that's what gave her trouble last week. No problems tonight. We'll bail right to that handstand position on low bar, full circle with the feet. We'll jump from low bar to high bar. Tip cast right up to the handstand. Giant. Giant swing. She has a double layout in the air and one step back on the landing. Actually rotated a little bit backwards toward the uneven bar, so judges can deduct for that also.
I'd like to see the score because it's going to show kind of what the judges are leaning for.
Right.
That was a similar routine to what we saw from Florida in the first quarter.
Beautiful handstands tonight for Mack Brennan.
Now for Florida, you're going to get Rachel Spicer. She's a senior standing at 5'1" from Hilland Village, Texas. A lot of the great gymnasts come out of the great state of Texas, Lisa.
That's right. Kind of a pipeline to the southeast.
I know.
Here comes Rachel. Still waiting for the scores to come in for both Brandon and Wang.
Spicer is down the runway for Florida. Yurchenko full in the air. A little tight body down and then takes a hop backward. Another good vault. The first one scoring a 9-9 for Kristen Wang.
Florida did not bring too many gymnasts here to Alabama. Obviously they have enough, but if you look at the numbers compared to Alabama, we considerably outnumber. Now for Alabama, it's going to be Keeley McNear. Keeley, one of the excellent gymnasts for the tie, competed excellently on the vault earlier today. Now she's trying to tackle the uneven bars for the Crimson Tide.
And Keeley will mount with a springboard jump to the high bar. Hip cast handstand. Ray release.
Wow.
Nicely caught, good height. Hip cast right back up to that handstand. Toe on handstand. Very aggressive bar worker. Back to the handstand position on low bar. Glide kick to stand on low bar. Jump to high bar. Hip cast handstand. A little short. Giant. Giant swing. She has a big double layout in the air. Fight for the landing, but does move a little bit. As she kind of windmills her arms, the judges can deduct there.
Absolutely. Some scores are in for both Alabama and Florida. Mac Brandon scores a 9.775 on that power routine. So the scoring, as we can imagine, is going to be similar to Florida's, so being very picky this evening.
Extremely critical of these uneven ball routines, and that is what Coach Brian Rashilla likes to see in judging.
Absolutely.
He doesn't like to see big scores thrown out when they're not deserved. He wants to see the big critique so they can have stuff to go back into the gym and work on.
Now for the Gators, it's time for Bridget Coquato.
Coquato, a junior for the Florida Gators. She is down the runway. She will throw a Yurchenko full, big chest, tight body down, takes a lunging step forward toward the vault, almost touched it, but kept her body and her hands away.
Touch the vault.
Touch the vault. It's a bigger deduction.
Bigger deduction, okay.
Right. So she was completely zero distance, number one, off the vault, chest, pike, body, pike, body all through, and then a big lunging forward.
Keeley McNair scores in for the tie. She scored a 9.825, so that's a pretty good score.
Topped out those handstand positions, really fought for that double layout dismount, not moving.
And now it's time to Katie Bailey, who's one of the most focused Alabama gymnasts when she attacks these bars. She had one phenomenal routine last week.
Kick cast to the handstand position on the high bar. Giant half. She throws a super high straddle Jaeger, nicely caught. Kick cast right back up to that handstand position. Will bail to the handstand position on low bar. Full circle with the feet. Will jump from low bar to high bar. Kick cast handstand. Giant. Giant swing. Katie has a tuck full out.
Wow.
And the foot moves at the final second. She really went for that landing. But a more difficult landing and a better one than we saw last week at Arkansas.
Alabama is pulling out all the stops here. It's a little home cooking. It's a Coleman Coliseum. They're giving Florida all they can handle right now. Now for the Gators, it's going to be Kennedy Baker, but I'll inform you of some of the scores before she attempts the runway. Kristen Wang scoring a 9.900, Spicer with a 9.850, Aka Quato scoring a 9.725 after that slip up on the end. Now Kennedy Baker is on the runway for the Gators.
Super freshman for them. Yurchenko full and a big hop backwards out of that full twist. Not ready for the landing. But quickly salutes the judges.
Lisa, you were saying that the Gators, this is their best event, the vault. Have they been somewhat underwhelming on this event so far?
A little bit, and again, it may be some fatigue.
Yep. On the road.
Again, Alabama had a little bit of that. You have to travel on the road. Yep. You have to, you're not familiar with the equipment. You only have, the long warm-ups and the four-minute touch to get used to something. So maybe some of their landings aren't as clean as they're normally accustomed to.
Now for Alabama, it's time for Asia Sims.
Asia will mount with a glide tip, two hands, stand on the low bar to jump to high bar. She will immediately throw her Komenich, which is a straddle front foot, into her Weiler tip. Half turn, bail to the handstand position on low bar. Straddle toe shoot from low bar to high bar, right up to that handstand position from the kip. Giant, giant swing, double layout in the air.
Wow!
The very last second, 1 foot, takes the back
leg. Ladies and gentlemen, Alabama's going to give Florida everything they can handle.
Now, in that routine, it went so fast, and she was so aggressive through all of those huge releases. The culminate, which is a straddle flip under the high bar to re-catch, then she immediately goes into her Weiler kick and then bails with the handset. So it's just going, going, going. She never has a chance to breathe in that ball routine.
J.D. Bailey scores a 9.800. Kennedy Baker on the vault for Florida scores a 9.825. Now it's time for Keetra Hunter.
Keetra Hunter, one of the best vaulters for the Florida Gators, the senior All-American, barrels down. She has an Yurchenko 1.5, and it's a stick landing.
My goodness, that was one of the most perfection routines I've seen in a long time, and she gets
body alignment in the air for that 1.5 twist. This will score extremely well for the Florida Gators.
Shouldn't surprise anybody for the Florida Gators. Keisha Hunter not only is one of the best vaulters in the SEC, she might just be one of the best vaulters in the country. Not a 10, but it's going to be darn close.
Just like Caitlin Clark, a 9.975.
Now for Alabama, it's time for Amanda Jetter. She's going to use the springboard, and she's on the uneven bar.
Jet will hip thrust up to the handstand position. Ray release, nicely caught. Hip cast handstand, beautiful positions on these handstands for Jet. She will bounce to the handstand position, bends her knees a little bit on that. It gets it under control with a straddle toe shoot from low bar to high bar. Giant half, I think she's in trouble. She's slowing down, but she pulls it around with a double front dismount stick.
Amanda,
she really slowed down on that giant half giant. I thought she was dead meat and going down, but boy, she pulled that dismount around.
I think Coach Brian Michelle knew she was in trouble too, with the excitement on his face when she landed that flawlessly. Now for Florida, it's time for super freshman Alex McMurtry from Midlothian, Virginia. She's a freshman. She's 5'2", and she's on the runway.
Alex, last week for the Florida Gators, scored a 10. A freshman, second meet of the season, young season for her, and she scored a 10 on the vault. That's what she can do for the Gators. Down the runway. Yurchenko flares out with the hands. That's how mastered she has with the twist, but she did take a hop back on the landing.
Almost that's effortless for some of these Gators.
It really does. The fact that you can flare your arm out of that full twist, that tells you how much hang time you had, and you had already finished that vault in the air.
Alabama is not, that was the final vaulter for the Gators. Alabama is not done on the uneven bars. You're going to get junior All-American Lauren Beers as she tapes her wrist, using her grips, getting ready to ascend to the uneven bars. Some scores from both teams. 9.900. So after this, the final, final halfway done. Alabama score of 98.825. Florida, 98.450, so Alabama clinging to a sling lead. When we come back, it's time for the beam in the floor. You're listening to the Capstone.
I'm Ashley Priest, and you're listening to the exclusive home of Alabama Gymnastics 90.7, the Capstone. 90.7.
We are back live here at Coleman Coliseum on the University of Alabama, where Alabama and Florida are going toe-to-toe. Currently, Alabama leads the Gators by a slim margin of 98.725 to Florida's 98.450. All right, Lisa, it's breaking time for Alabama.
It is.
Last week, this is where we were killed on the balance beam.
Yeah, it's put-up time for the balance beam team of the Crimson Tide, and we like warm-ups. Long warm-ups look good. And again, we highlighted in the pre-meet the shift. The coaches said they were going to change the lineup. They have put senior All-American Kayla Williams as the leadoff position instead of the anchor position. I think it's a more natural fit for Kayla. She did it the first 2 years of her career at Alabama. It's a natural feel for her. She is going to set the table for this Crimson Tide beam team.
Are you surprised to see Asia Sims in the cleanup squad?
Nope, she's earned it.
Absolutely. All right, now for Alabama, it's time for senior Kayla Williams. She was one of the three that fell last week. She's a senior. She's a captain. She's an All-American. She has the ability to put this behind her and go on her beam and do what she does.
And it's going to be interesting, too, because the dock she had on the vault, but then managed to put around the 1.5 on the second attempt, will that factor in, you know, a little hood problem tonight? And I hope not, because such a great leadership Kayla brings to this team. And you can see it in her face. She
she needs to do Kayla's routine. Don't take on any more. Set the table. Be calm. Attack this. You own this beam.
Maybe there were some thoughts that she had a little nerves when she came down on the vault. Nonetheless, she came in her second routine, absolutely stuck it. So this senior, the vocal leader, as I say, because if we've been on the trips with them, there's no one who's undisputed the vocal leader on this team is Kayla Williams. And now our friends at the SEC Network are ready to go, and Kayla Williams is ready to take the balance beam and take it away, Kayla and Lisa.
Kayla will mount with a running jump using the springboard to the very end of the balance beam and will quickly throw a huge straddle, side straddle leap. Tiny little bobble out of that, but she quickly camouflaged it, as with military appreciation. I don't really appreciate that. Punch front. Tiny little push up. We call it squeezing up to the stand position. So just, again, a few little nerves at the beginning of this, but they're tiny. Just needs to relax. Don't let the shoulders rise. Just relax and breathe. You've got this, Kayla. Setting up for her flight series. She will throw a back handspring to back layout step
wow.
out right on.
Gets an ovation from the crowd.
Beautiful arms and leg work Kayla brings to the beam, so polished in all of her moves. Flutter jump. Straddle full turn right on a dime. Perfect.
Wow.
Needs to keep her focus and concentration. The big stuff is out of the way, but it's the little stuff that can kill you. Beautiful full turn. It's a requirement in a balance beam routine, as is working down onto, touching the balance beam, and working above and on it. Kayla will dismount with a round off, one and a half twist, and a little step forward. And a quick salute to the judges.
Unbelievable. To put last week behind her and come onto this balance beam and have one solid performance.
And I think we heard just a collective sigh as the entire Bama Nation in Coleman Coliseum finally took a breath with Kayla.
Absolutely. Now on the floor for Florida. This is an area where they absolutely dominate teams, and you're going to see Claire Boy. I expect to see some gator chomp in here, Lisa.
Every routine has the gator chomp choreographed into it. I'm sure the Tide fans will
love it.
Show their appreciation for it. Claire Boyce, a sophomore for the Florida Gators. She will lead off the Gators. Beautiful flexibility showing off in the beginning of this choreographed routine. One of their taller gymnasts. Front handspring to one and a half twist. A little loose in the legs in the twisting part, but just a tiny little deduction for form.
Okay, we talked about it last week. Always great to see the different music these teams bring in.
And the different choreographed styles of the coaches. Round off, one and a half twist to front height. Leg lift in a scale at the end of it to show mastery. Drops down to the mat, working low, again for more flexibility and choreography. Just real pretty presentation on the floor. Tour jeté, straddle, full, her leap combination. And there's the top at the very end.
Gator boat.
Deep breath before she will take off. The final tumbling pass of a front handspring, Rudy. That's one and a half twist. And final in pose. So a nice start for the Florida Gators for Claire Boyce.
Claire Boyce had a good routine. I busted Kayla Williams, who's scoring there at 9.850. So she's got to be thrilled with that score.
Well done. Well done, Kayla. Great comeback from last week.
And now last week, another gymnast who fell, who I would have been the last gymnast to fall, is Katie Bailey.
Katie had never fallen in her career at Alabama.
She hopes to keep that up as I knock wood right now.
I think I set up two of them last week. Katie will mount with a straddle seat mount. Crosses her legs. And then swings her legs backwards to work her way up to her feet to begin her balance beam routine. Solid full turn, leg in the lift position, all the way around her revolution.
Thank God for this Jumbotron, because our view is blocked.
Back handspring to back layout, step out, straight line for Katie. And what's unusual for Katie tonight, normally she competes with her hair in a tight top knot bun. Tonight she's got a ponytail. Pitch kick to side summy, beautiful. Straight line, body and chest are high when she lands, showing mastery of that skill. Switch leap into tuck jump.
Wow.
Into flutter jump combination.
I just love how Katie Bailey competes every week. She's one of my favorite gymnasts.
So smooth, and like Kayla, so polished in all of her moves. She will dismount with a round off, one and a double twist. Big shot landing.
Wow.
Double twist from Katie.
I just saw one of the Florida players just kind of shrugging, kind of anger, because she knows that Alabama is giving them all they can handle, and the crowd here at Coleman is absolutely loving it. Student section filled. Crimson Chaos section film, ROTC section being honored today. As Lisa said, it is Military Appreciation Night. Now for Florida, it's time for Erica Fassbender.
Another freshman for the Gators.
From Katy, Texas. Anybody likes Friday Night Lights?
Fassbender will mount with a round off, back handspring. Two and a half twists to punch front. And a lot of gator chomping in that choreo right there. She got three chomps in. Second tumbling pass. Round off back handspring. Double pike. Very nice landing. Good height. Showing difficulty putting the double pike in the second tumbling run. Move to K, half turn, using some Latin salsa music.
Very different than voices routine.
To ring leap, straight leg hitch kick. As she dances her way into the corner, she'll take off for a final tumbling pass of round off, one and a half twist to front pike.
Wow. Florida is complete cash here on the on the floor. Has been two routines that have been excellent. Boys' score has come in at a 9.800. And for Alabama, we knew Katie Bailey's score was going to be good. I'm not sure. I thought it was going to be this good. 9.900.
Well deserved for Katie.
Excellent.
Nothing to deduct in that beam routine. It was flawless from beginning to end.
Now for the Crimson Tide, it's time for Keely McNear. Is she all around tonight? Is she doing all four?
Keely will not be doing the floor for Alabama tonight.
So she's 3 of 4. She's been excellent on both the vault and the uneven bars. Did she compete last week in Arkansas on the beam?
She did.
She did not fall. She was not one of the three that fell. So Keely McNear is trying to keep the good, keep on going. She's on the beam.
Front aerial to flutter jump as Keely is quickly mounts onto the balance beam with a quick step up from the side. She will set up her flight series of a back handspring to back layout, step out, solid. And Keely was one of the gymnasts that the coaches looked to get Bama back on track last week, and she did her job for the Crimson Tide.
Only a sophomore, correct?
Sophomore. Switch leap into split leap jump. Nice amplitude on both of those splits. Solid full turn from Keely. We are hoping sometime this season we're going to see her attempt the double turn she has in her arsenal for the balance beam. Drops down to pose on the balance beam, working low to the beam and on top of it. Nice side aerial to flutter jump. Beautiful tonight. She had a little trouble with that connection last week, but did stay on the beam for the Crimson Tide. She was perfect tonight. She will dismount with a round off, one and a half twist. She nails that landing. Bama got the message in practice this week.
Keely McNear, pretty much, I would say, flawless, because there was some slight mix-ups. But in three events tonight, she has to be one of the standout performers for the Crimson Tide.
Absolutely. What a clutch time performer for the Crimson Tide last week on the beam for Alabama. And tonight, she goes even better, because this was a much better much cleaner beam routine that will score well for the Crimson Tide.
Now for the Gators, it's time for Kirsten Waring, the civil engineering major from Virginia. Interesting start.
Showing great flexibility with a...
Does she just touch her nose with her heel?
She does a chest stand and arches over with her leg, showing off her flexibility. Beautiful move.
I can't even bend over to take out the trash.
Cue him out with a roundoff, back handspring, double tuck.
Wow.
Nice opening.
This girl's absolute nails, folks.
Second tumbling pass for Kirsten Wing. Front handspring, front layout to... I'll be honest, we'll come back to that because maybe there was a little bit of a problem in there and she didn't throw something extra.
Try to camouflage you with your gators.
Yeah, right there. So she paid to split half, to straddle half. I definitely want to take a look at the video on that second tumbling pass. She does a lot of one half turns, showing a lot of unique choreography, intricate moves.
The judges do not have access to video after, do they?
No. There is no video replay in gymnastics. Round up, back handspring, double pike to end, a little chest down, held the pike a little long, so they're lunging step forward, but saved it. But so there's some problems in both of those second and third tumbling runs, and I'm thinking the half out of her front pike should have been a full, but we'll see.
Some scores are in for Florida. Erica Fassbender's score comes in at a 9.825. Wang just competed. And for Alabama, Keely McNear scores a 9.875, another high score for the time. And now it's time for Lauren Beers, who is attempting to add to this lead for Alabama. She's on the balancing.
Keep the beam machine rolling, Bama. Lauren will mount with a quick jump up from the springboard to the end of the balance beam, switch leap, split leap combination. Grabs her knee and bends that leg straight behind her body in a beautiful scale position. Side summy, very nice. Lauren will set up for her flight series. Back handspring to back layout, step out, no problems tonight.
The difficulty there is just unbelievable.
And where Alabama last week, all three gymnasts fell in their flight series. So far tonight, they've made up for it.
Four for four.
Beautiful full turn from Lauren. She will keep the focus going. She'll throw a back head roll down low onto the balance beam. I love that move. It's difficult, but it's such a unique move, and she makes it look so easy.
Alabama is doing everything they need to do to beat these Gators.
Flutter jump into sheet jump combination. Tiny little foot movement forward, but she quickly dances out of it. It's a tiny, tiny form deduction. Deep breath, and Lauren will dismount with a round off, one and a half twist, and one step back on the landing. Really stretched the distance on that twist in the air.
Yep.
Really going for the six catch. So she came in actually almost with her basically touched a little bit. Almost like you're sitting down in a chair because she stretched the distance she got on that twist so far out. So if she kind of cut back a little on the distance, she may have nailed that. Fantastic routine.
Now for the Gators, it's time for Kennedy Baker, one of the super freshmen that Alabama tried to get. She was heavily recruited by the time.
Yeah, everybody in the nation wanted this talented freshman.
Katie Baker from Flower Mound, Texas. Wow, the way she just glides on the floor.
Now, we'll see if she's going to throw the E-opening of round-off back handspring. She does. It's called a Dos Santos. It is a Arabian pike.
Some Latin fire to that.
And she had a little bit of a stiff landing, but it's such a difficult move. It's one of the hardest stumbling passes in college gymnastics. In the world, actually, that is a world-level opening stumbling pass. Round up, backhand screen, double pike, no problem, stairs. Kennedy fights back from that opening tumbling run. Alabama's Sarah last year was training the Dos Santos.
Wow.
Beautiful turns to Jay split full. Nice music for Kennedy. Showing off a different style.
Kennedy Baker, who was excellent on the vault earlier, having an excellent routine here
about
on the floor.
One and a half. Rudy to leap jump.
Wow.
An illusion. Very nice routine. A few little problems here and there for form.
Especially on the landing.
But that impressive Dos Santos was on the opening tumbling run.
Yep.
Amazing.
That's going to get her some points.
That will.
Kennedy Baker with a very good score. Or excuse me, her score hasn't come in yet. Kirsten Wang's score has come in, and it's a little underwhelming. 9.725 for the seniors. So, again, these four routines, they're being watched and judged strictly and harshly for Alabama. Lauren Beers' score has come in, 9.850. So Alabama's slowly moving along, and now it's time for senior captain Caitlin Clark.
Caitlin Clark mounts with a full body stretch position on the balance beam, and then quickly works her way up to her feet. She will throw a split leap out of a switch leap combination. Beautiful extension toes always pointed for Caitlin. She will immediately set up her flight series. Back handspring to back layout step out.
Wow.
Right on.
Is there a comfort level to your own balance beam at home, or is it all psychological?
Probably a little more comfortable with this. It's worked in. They've pounded on it all season long in practice. Beautiful flutter jump to sheep jump combination. Solid full turn. They know the springiness of it.
Yep.
They kind of know the ins and outs, the squeaks.
Because like a comparison, a basketball player, when I used to play high school basketball, you'd go to other gyms, you'd be used to some of these different rims, these backboards, they all have different touches to them.
And the problem she had last week with the front aerial kickover into flutter jump, she nailed tonight. And the crowd gave her an appreciative applause. This team has worked so hard this week, and boy, it's showing in competition tonight on the balance beam. Caitlin sets up for her dismount of a round-off, one-and-a-half twist, and one little step forward on the landing. Well done.
Alabama taking care of business tonight. And as you said earlier, Asia Sims will round it off for the Crimson Tide. One of the best practice performances the Tide have ever seen, according to Dana Duckworth. She works so hard in the gym.
She does. And for Asia, she's been moved back into that anchor position. She has earned that cleanup title. Because she has, for 2 weeks in a row, delivered big-time beam performances for the Crimson Tide.
Now
last week, a 9-9
wow.
at Arkansas.
Now for the Gators, it's time for Keetra Hunter from Frederick, Maryland.
Dynamic personality, fantastic tumbler. Keetra Hunter brings it all to the floor, the Gators, and attitude on the floor exercise.
She kind of reminds me of Asia Sims when it comes to on the floor.
Yes.
Her attitude.
So athletic, too, looking. Round up
wow.
a handspring, beautiful double layout.
Again, we are watching the highest level of collegiate gymnastics. We take for granted what amazing athletes these girls are.
And they don't water it down when it comes to college gymnastics from the U.S. and
yep.
world level. They really bring it. Round off, one and a half to front layout, front handspring to straddle to Sanova. A lot of tumbling in that second pass. She will get big time bonus.
Keetra Hunter, famous for her double layout, half twist from layout into our open double tuck.
Yeah, she's well known for her open body position of her double tuck. We also see it on the uneven bars dismount if she doesn't throw the double layout. Round off that handspring, the open double tuck, and nails the landing.
That's what we were talking about.
Pitch kick, drop down to the knee, and does a little bit of worm.
That worm?
That's the worm.
Wow.
So this will float very close to perfection.
Unbelievable. Caitlin Clark scores, and she ties her teammate Lauren Beers with a 9.850. So Alabama, another solid performance, and they are one away from Asia Sims now. As we said, Dana Duckworth just raves about her athleticism and her work ethic.
And don't ever forget the ever-present smile.
Oh, my goodness. Ear to ear.
Ear to ear. Loves what she's doing. From a knee pose, Asia moves quickly onto her feet to begin her balance beam routine. Works very light and always up on her toes. Nice front aerial into split leap. Tiny little bit of hesitation between the two moves. We'll see if the judges do give her connection. Sets up for a flight series of back handspring, to back layout, step out, solid.
She's a quick gymnast. She goes quick.
She does. Same thing. She attacks the uneven bar. She attacks the beam. Switch leap. Straddle leap combination. Right on. Super extended half straddle leap, or what we call a side straddle leap. Solid full turn. She overextends when she leaps. I'm sure it got the attention of the Alabama cheerleaders in attendance tonight. That's how you do a straddle leap.
Lisa, that proud sorority of Alabama gymnastics players that originally were cheerleaders.
A little trouble tonight on the dismount as they round off a double tuck, one of the most difficult dismounts.
Yep.
And she says that she under-rotated it a bit, took a step forward toward the beam. That's pretty much the only deduction in that balance beam.
Alabama on the beam, just take a minute to talk about how unbelievable that turnaround was.
I mean, it's literally night and day difference between how they performed last week. They were uptight. They were, shoulders were high, tight. They were scared they were going to fall. They weren't trusting each other tonight. They got into that gym this past week, and now you just see that trust factor, and they just believe each one was going to deliver a key performance tonight, and they have.
You said Q's 100 score would be close to perfect. It almost is. 9.975. And now for the Gators taking the floor is Bridget Cusquato.
The junior will start her tumbling run of a front handspring, 2.5 twist to front pike. And dangerously close to that line using the soft mat.
The back end of these Gator routines are just unbelievable with the talent they have.
So a little movement on that mat. We'll see what the judges, there will be a small deduction, but there was movement on that landing using the soft mat. Cicado into the corner for her second tumbling pass. Front handspring. 2.5 twist to split knee. Back extension roll. Working down low onto the mat. Trying to get some breath. Working in choreography.
Music changed. Wow.
Started out slow. Now it's getting nice and high beat. Straddle pull. Megan, maybe a little Duck Dynasty choreo going on with the shoulders. Round off that handspring, double pike to end.
Wow.
The ankles are a little soft on that landing, but she gets it around.
Another high score would be huge for Florida. That was pretty great. Deidre Hunter and Bridget Cusquato showing why they are national champions. Unbelievable.
And again, pretty much no weakness on any of the events. Alabama themselves are showing no weakness on any of their rotations.
Asia Sims scored 9.850. Unbelievable on the beam. We're going to wait for Cusquato's score. We're going to take a quick break. But when we come back, hold up your fours. It's the fourth quarter. You're listening to 90.7 FM, The Capstone.
I'm Ashley Sledge, and you're listening to the exclusive home of Alabama Gymnastics, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7.
this week's episode, Fire at the Shed.
Gee, Johnny, this rope swing sure is slow.
Don't I know it.
Hey, it's Sassy. I think she's trying to tell us something. Mr. Gunderson? What about Mr. Gunderson? A fire? Mr. Gunderson's trapped? Where, Sassy, where? What, Sassy? Now that you've got our attention, you'd like to take a moment to talk about shelter pets? Shelter pets in general are well-adjusted, healthy, and love being with people?
Sassy, we don't have time!
Pets often end up in shelters due to owner problems like divorce or allergies?
That's great, Sassy, but what about the fire?
There is no fire! You're just messing with our heads?
Sassy!
Sassy is brought to you by the Ad Council and the ShelterPetProject.org. Remember, adopt!
If you're about to purchase a new mower, chainsaw, generator, or other piece of outdoor power equipment, you need to know how to protect it. For instance, the gasoline you put in. I'm Chris Kaiser, president of the Outdoor Power Equipment Institute. Most gas now contains 10% ethanol, and that's okay. But some gas pumps are changing. Higher ethanol gas blends, like E15, E30, and E85, may be available at a local station, and they may be cheaper. But it's harmful and illegal to use in outdoor power equipment. And what you put in your car may no longer be safe for other engines. When getting gas, look before you pump. Price is no longer the way to choose your fuel. You have to choose the right fuel, because not having the right fuel for the right product can damage or destroy the equipment. Look before you pump. Protect your equipment. Stick with E10 or less. A consumer can find out about which fuels are appropriate for outdoor power equipment use at lookbeforeyoupump.com.
I'm Jerome Stack-Eaton, and you're listening to the exclusive home of Alabama Gymnastics, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7!
Welcome back to Coleman Coliseum here at the University of Alabama. And Lisa, the dreams are reality right now. Alabama has a shot to upset the defending national champion, Florida Gators. And Alabama, I don't think there's a place they'd rather be than on the floor right now. Last week, they were absolutely money on this floor.
They were. That lineup last week delivered the best tumbling series dance, everything that the coaches could ask for. And we want to see that performance go up a little bit higher with the presentation being in front of the home crowd. So what's in front of you is a chance to knock off the number one team in the country. If you do your best floor performance in the lineup they have in there tonight, look out, Crimson Tide fans.
Lisa, what can you tell us quickly about Florida on the beam?
Florida on the beam is a very confident, very... They have a lot of difficulty, some beautiful choreography. So just like everywhere else, they're very polished on that event also.
One other thing, do you expect the crowd to get involved with Florida on the beam right now?
Well, it's a very knowledgeable gymnastics crowd, Alabama is. So they're going to have good sportsmanship for the Florida Gators. But if Florida opens the door, you will get some
Here we go. Florida needs championship resolve right now because they are staring a big old L in the face. Kennedy Baker, the talented freshman, man, as a freshman on this team.
She's had a great night so far for the Florida Gators here in Coleman Coliseum.
Let's see if the nerves can potentially get to her. I doubt it. She's one of the best young gymnasts this country has to offer. She gets the green light, and she is coming to the beam.
She will mount with a little pommel horse half swing to stag leap. And from that stag position, she will throw a full turn on the balance beam. She actually does two turns. That's almost a Humphrey, named after Alabama's Taryn Humphrey. Unfortunately, she swung herself off. So a fall to begin with for Kennedy Baker. But that is such a difficult opening mount.
And the Alabama team knows they have a real shot now, looking over at them.
Front aerial into back handspring. As she gets herself back under control, emotionally and for her gymnastics. Split leap into split half turn. Very nice combination. Difficult.
Conservative routine thus far.
taking a long time to set up this dismount of a round-off, double-tuck dismount, little hop forward. That's why, because it's crazy. Such a difficult. The same dismount that Asia and A. Sims of Alabama throws in. She took her time setting it up because you've got to be precise on it. Those feet miss.
Now for Alabama, it's the Ichiro Suzuki of Alabama gymnastics, Katie Bailey, trying to get on base in this equivalent, trying to put up one heck of a score for Alabama. Their door is open. Now it's time for the Tide to kick it down.
Alabama's Katie Bailey was not in the floor lineup last week, but she is back in tonight.
I'll pick Katie Bailey any day of the week on any, for any event.
Absolutely. Again, will we see the upgrade in difficulty? That's the question.
Eye contact with the judge to start. That's always a good sign.
And a big smile on Katie's face because she's got her home crowd in her court. Burlesque music for Katie. Punch front, round off. Back handspring, two and a half twist. Wow, Katie stuck that landing.
Wow. Showtime. We used to talk about the Showtime Lakers. Magic Johnson.
Split leap combination to full turn.
I think we got Showtime Bama now.
Bama is in the Bama zone. Bama bubble, as we call it. Front bounder. Just right on. She does that from a running position. The front bounder, it's basically a layout, but she's in a running position, so it's a little more difficult to throw that full turn out of full twist out of it. Some barrel rolls as she works down low to the floor. And, of course, the head always high in her dance presentation, making eye contact with everybody in this arena. We're actually seeing a little more personality from Katie tonight. Normally she is a little bit of a shy.
Again, one of the most focused gymnasts Alabama has to offer. Brian Rochella gives a high five to Dana Duckworth.
And she is with a
wow.
One and a half twist, Rudy.
Some people are standing here in Coleman. Katie Bailey. A big roll tide from the Alabama faithful. Now Florida, it's time for Rachel Spicer.
And that last tumbling pass for Katie, the front handspring to one and a half twist. It's a Rudy. That was so smooth.
Kennedy Baker's score comes in at a 9.300. So Florida's hoping that's the score they're going to have to drop because it's a less than enthusiastic start for the Gators here in the fourth quarter.
Rachel Spicer will mount with a tuck knee toe and then quickly works her way up to her feet. Back handspring. Back layout, step out, step away. Small form deduction that quickly works her way out of it. Quick hitch kick.
Nice save.
Solid full turn. A little nervy after that fall. She knows she's got to stay on this beam for her team.
Again, on the road, this is a difficult routine to do.
Hitch kick to standing gainer. Back layout, step out. Switch leap into a heck down to the balance beam.
Support
with her hips. Cartwheel into gainer full.
Nice.
Off the side of the beam. Very nice landing. So she gets to gainer back on track with that beam performance.
Rachel Spicer, a very talented routine for the Gators. And now it's time for Asia Sims on the floor, and the Alabama student section rises to their feet. Rochella down on one knee, almost the same size as Coach Duckworth on one knee. Here comes Asia. Scores have come in for Katie Bailey of a 9.875, so a great start for Alabama. Sims trying to continue.
Sims wants to continue this. Asia will bring the enthusiastic dance that she is so known for.
The best smile in West Alabama has to go to Asia Sims.
Beautiful standing split half. Now, you got to control the emotions and the adrenaline. Round off, back handspring, double pike, nice. Because this crowd can pump you up, but they can pump you up too much that you lose a little bit of focus and control, but not in that first tumbling pass. straddle, straddle full. Wow, just a beautiful landing.
Dang.
Look at that attitude and that jab. She is having the time of her life. Second tumbling pass for Asia. Round off, 1.5. Full twist.
Wow.
Full twist, front layout. Let me get it accurate.
Down to one knee. A little shimmy shake.
This is where Asia's getting her breathing exercises in. She's got to go big at the end. Well, final tumbling pass for Asia.
Here comes Asia spin.
Round off. Back handspring. Double tuck. It's a great one.
Wow.
Straddle leap. Drop down.
Wow. Lisa, there's a little D word that just crept in on the Florida sideline, and that's the word called out. Because if Alabama continues this, the Crimson Tide might just hold on and become victorious. But that's not, if anything, Alex McMurtry has to say about it. The talented freshman. Score has come in for Spicer. It's a 9.75. So again, I thought that might have been a little higher.
Rachel Spicer has owned the beam.
McMurtry.
Spicer got a 9.775. McMurtry throws huge punch front. Back handspring to back layout. Step out.
That's nice. Solid.
She gets such great air in all of her acrobatic moves.
Again, we were talking about earlier how Florida loves to finish their routines with some of their best gymnasts.
And she throws a switch leap down to a hex, and then she will actually tip underneath the balance beam back onto a hip support. So it's a full turn, but the full turn throws her off balance a bit. She has to fight it and quickly drops down to a knee pose to camouflage.
Some Velcro feet for this young lady, my goodness.
She's a competitor. She's been on the world and U.S. level for gymnastics, and she will dismount with a 2.5 twist, extremely difficult dismount, super landing. That was a very fast, you notice how fast that beam routine was done. She just threw those moves and got off.
Now for Alabama, probably my favorite gymnast when it comes to the floor exercise, and that's Carly Sims. She has a great time when she competes on the floor here.
How do you pick one? I mean, they're all fantastic.
I
think
the shoulder routine she always pulls. The spoken enthusiasm.
A little bit more because she's homegrown. She's Alabama. She's Birmingham. So a little.
The favoritism.
A little more favorite place in our heart.
Everyone wants a hometown hero, and now for Alabama, here is Carly Sims.
Round off, back handspring, double layout. Nice. That gets the crowd's attention. Super landing for Carly. Front handspring, front full to front pike. Nice. Those are almost back-to-back tumbling passes. Takes a lot of endurance to do those. Working down low into the mat. This is where your favorite dance comes in, and that attitude. And she shows it in her facial expression. She's looking at that tension and saying, yeah, work with me.
This crowd can be a powerful ally.
Straddle, split, half.
One of the funniest members of the Alabama team, getting to spend a week with them last week in Fayetteville. She's a fun time.
She looks like she would be great. Yeah.
Is the dirt off her shoulder.
All right, dust it off, Carly. Bring it home.
Here she comes.
Round off, that handspring, double pike.
You go, Carly Sims.
Butterfly to a half barrel roll.
Yeah.
Right on top.
Yeah, people are on their feet here at Coleman Coliseum.
I think that's her best one of the season.
This building is vibrating.
It was tough to beat that performance last week at Arkansas, but I think she just did.
Wow. Gets a big old hug from Dana Duckworth. And she's going to hold it there for a second. My God. Now it's time for Florida. Claire Boris, Alex McMurtry scores at a 9.825.
Another good score, but not a great score for the Gators.
Nice head forward roll for her mount.
Again, you never underestimate a champion like these Gators are, or at least the co-champion. We won't underestimate Oklahoma when they come to Tuscaloosa.
Front aerial into back handspring combination. Claire Boyce will set up for her flight series of a back handspring to back layout step out. Solid. Gators are fighting back after that initial fall from Kennedy Baker at the beginning. So far, they've been right on.
They're going to work for her full twist dismount. Media guy says that. That's one of the most difficult, is it not?
It's very difficult. As she throws a solid full turn and then works down low, arches back over from a back position on the bounce beam, working down low, showing off strength and flexibility, and then comes up to a nice flutter jump leap. Switch leap, split leap combination. Showing great confidence in this routine. Boyce will dismount with a cartwheel, gain her full off the side of the beam.
That was nice.
Didn't throw the more difficult dismount tonight, probably because of the fall they went with the safer dismount.
Absolutely. Now
they want a good road score.
For Alabama, you have Asia Sims, you have Carly Sims. So with the same last name, how about you give them the same score? 9.850 for the both of them.
With Carly has deductions built in, and they're working on this. The coaches, Dana talks about this, is the leap combination. They've got to work that out because they're just, and that's where they hit her. They didn't hit her anywhere else, but they did hit her there.
Senior All-American Caitlin Clark taken away on the floor.
And a huge smile on her face, but Caitlin's got to control her emotions because she can go way too big in her tumbling series. So she wants to be in control. And last week again at Arkansas, we keep going back to that because it was such a fabulous sports exercise performance for the Crimson Tide. Caitlin will mount with a round-off back handspring, super high double pipe. Great control. Split half, split full.
With three competitors to go for each team, Alabama nearly up by an entire point.
I want to keep that momentum going. Stay focused. Round off one and a half twist to front layout.
Wow.
Leg lift and a scale to show she's got total control of that front tumbling pass. Now, Caitlin has to be careful because toward the end of this, she hasn't stopped moving yet in this routine, so there's nowhere for her to gather her breath for the final tumbling pass. So she's got to dig deep into that fall training and endurance to finish this floor routine for the Crimson Tide.
And senior can't allow fatigue to potentially limit this upset. Here she goes.
Round off, backhand spring, double cut, nice! Super high chest high. Ring leap, drop down pose.
Caitlin Clark. Wowzers. She's got a big old smile on her face. She's going to be greeted by her teammates. She's one of the most excited gymnasts. Yeah, we were right in front of her at the vault. Smiling ear to ear. Absolute glee.
A huge hug from her coach, Brian Rochelle, on the floor.
We talked about Alabama needing to be flawless. They have been all night. With two, knock on wood again.
Yeah, two to go.
We all leave for us to go. They've been excellent. Now, Florida, it's time for Erica Fassbender.
Fassbender mounts with a straddle split leap on the beam, showing off her flexibility.
Expect some front aerial flip-flop layouts and a beat jump to a sheep jump.
The talented freshman already working high on her toes, Revelé. Front aerial, a little shoulder drop that causes her not to throw a combination. She can put it somewhere else in her beam routine. Another front aerial, and again, another hesitation.
Yep.
Lifts the leg in a balance check.
Florida,
the judges are going to hit her for that.
Florida, at this point, needs remarkable scores. And
back
she's
handspring, back layout step out. Yeah, the judges don't like to see a move repeated. Leaning down a little bit with her chest as she went into that leap. Solid full turn, back on track. Flutter jump into sheep jump combination. That was nice.
Do you expect a difficult dismount trying to get points back or play it safe for the road school?
Possibly, but she's got to go with what she's trained.
Yep.
Side aerial into a full twist. That was a nice landing. That's difficult because she combined the two. The side aerial immediately into a back full twist.
Caitlin Clark scores in, and it's a 9.900. And now Alabama and the student section are on their feet for the junior All-American. It's time for Lauren Beers. Or as we say back home, Lauren Beers.
A little Boston accent coming in. We call you Johnny Boston for a reason.
Here comes the junior Lauren Beers on the floor trying to put it away for the Tide.
Lauren took the week off last week and did not tumble at Arkansas for the Crimson Tide. Mac Brannon took her place. Mac's getting a rest this week.
That's a good problem to have.
It is.
We have.
There's a lot of depth on the floor for the Crimson Tide. And the big tumbling will come for Lauren on the opening with a roundout back handspring, double layout.
Wow.
Triple landing. One of her best landings all season. Super dramatic music, almost movie music.
To try to rip off Mark Jackson, you got to say, tumble, young lady, tumble.
Front handspring, front layout.
Wow.
Nice landing.
As Beers is in their routine, a score for fast bender, only a 9.700.
Green leap to split full, drop down. I'm going to question myself on that second tumbling pass. We'll talk at the end.
Okay.
Because I think we did have something to go, but boy, did she cover it beautifully.
Again, the camouflage, I know.
It is. It's very nice. We're seeing camouflage.
Incredibly evident.
Final tumbling pass, deep breath before Lauren takes off for a round off back handspring, double touch, brings it high.
So elegant, so veteran, such a leader on this team.
Now, what we expected on the second tumbling pass for Lauren is the front handspring, front full to front layout.
Yep.
But what we saw was a Randy, a half twist.
Okay.
Actually, a half out of that front. So I'm going to be watching the start value of what this floor exercise routine to see if that was enough to keep her start value at 10.0, which I think it is.
Do the judges know the routines that are going to be attempted?
They don't know the routines, but they do know the start value.
Now it's time for Keisha Hunter, arguably the best gymnast this Florida team has to offer.
And she does a back head roll to a knee pose position in her beam routine to get herself started. Back handspring to back layout step out. Nice and straight. Ends high on her toes. Solid full turn from Keidra. So polished and so confident on this apparatus. Hitch kick into straddle quarter. Taps the back of the balance beam. We'll set up for a round off. Double tech dismount, just a little hop backwards on that. So we get another solid beam routine. Keisha Hunter has delivered tonight for the Florida Gators.
Again, Keisha Hunter, arguably one of the best gymnasts this nation has to offer.
And difficult dismount like Asia and her other teammate that threw the double.
And now it's time for Laura Leafrost. She has yet to compete all night, but she's a staple here on the floor. She was phenomenal, I remember, week one against Arizona here. She was the cleanup hitter for the Tide, trying to put it away and beat the number one seed, Florida Gators.
And Laura Lee's in that anchor position for a reason. She has big dance and big tumbling, but we want to see a little more animation come out of that face tonight. She's got her home crowd, so that's what the coaches really want from her, to elevate this floor routine. Round off, back handspring, double layout,
bang!
Solid. Flutter jump, straddle full, wolf full combination, double stag half turn drop down knee pose.
Wow.
Backs herself into that corner. Second tumbling pass for Laura Lee. Front full to front tuck. There's trouble on that front pass. It's supposed to be a front layout, front full.
Hunter scores bounder. 9.800.
Moon walk, Michael Jackson tribute. Split leap, straddle leap, combination. She will get hit for that second tumbling pass. Definitely deductions in it. She had to kind of almost bail herself out of it. So her start value, I'm almost guaranteeing, will drop. Final tumbling pass. Round off. Back handspring. Double pike.
Wow.
Solid difficulty at the end, but she opened the door on the middle pass. It won't be a super high score, but it'll be a good score.
It was a fight, but not high score. Laura Lee Frost just twisted dagger. Because that might just do it here in Coleman Coliseum. We will wait for the official judges' scores with bated breath.
But you've got to imagine, Lisa, that might be enough.
That should be enough, because technically you could throw out her score. Bama already has a 49.35.
That's it.
And we're waiting for, we got Keeker Hunter's 9.8 on the beam, so that's pretty much it.
That's it. Alabama has done it. The Alabama Crimson Tide has knocked off the queen of college gymnastics. The Florida Gators have come into Coleman Coliseum, and they did not compete poorly. Alabama competed up to their level, if not better.
Bama just, they used this crowd, they took their performance, their difficulty, their execution to a new level that we haven't seen so far this season. But again, it's a young season. It's the third meet of the week. They learned from last week. They did not like leaving Arkansas with that performance.
Yep.
And it was on national TV. So they were, they did not like.
Especially on the balance beam.
They
phenomenal.
Did not like how they performed. They did not show their best Alabama gymnastics for national TV and for themselves and that Crimson Leo. They went back into the gym. They figured out what was wrong. They called on each other to be more team-oriented.
Yep.
And look what we got tonight, that performance.
We're going to take a quick break. We're going to be right back with the official final scores. It's not official yet, but Alabama has defeated the Florida Gators. You're listening to 90.7 FM, The Capsule.
I'm Marissa Gutierrez, and you're listening to the exclusive home of Alabama Gymnastics, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7!
Okay, forest animals, kids are coming to the forest, and it's up to us to make their visit a good one. Sparrow, have you practiced the most popular bird songs for the year?
Of course.
Catchy. I like it. River, how's the temperature?
It's a refreshing 52 degrees, man.
I love it. Turtle.
He's not here yet, man.
He's late every morning. Okay. Squirrel.
The forest has been preparing just for you. To learn more about cool things to do in the forest, visit discovertheforest.org. Brought to you by the U.S. Forest Service and the Ad Council.
Hey, Dad.
Yeah?
You remember that ball game we went to a couple years ago?
Sure.
And how you didn't have enough cash for two hot dogs, so you walked with me on your shoulders until we found an ATM? And then when we got back to our seats, we never saw the hot dog guy again.
Well, I don't remember all that.
Yeah, that was an awesome game.
You never know which moments will be the ones they'll remember forever. So take time to be a dad today. Learn more at 1-877-4DAD-411 or visit fatherhood.gov.
Brought to you by the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services and the Ad Council.
This is Coach Lou Holtz with a message for guys 18 to 25. No matter what team you're on, take a quick time out and play for America. How? Register with Selective Service. It's easy. Register online at www.sss.gov or at any post office. It's not an option play, guys. It's a law. And it keeps you eligible for college loans, government job, and job training. So take five for America. Register with Selective Service. It's what every young man's got to do. Your exclusive home for Alabama gymnastics is right here, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7.
Welcome back to Coleman Coliseum. If you hear Yay Alabama in the background, that's for a reason, because your Alabama Crimson Tide have defeated the number one ranked Florida Gators. It's a score of 197.40 to 196.800. One unbelievable victory for the Crimson Tide, Lisa. On paper, you know we could do it. We were just waiting to see it with our own eyes be put together, and it's such an awesome thing to see on play tonight here in Military Appreciation Night.
It is, and I know the coaches knew what they had, but now the problem is, okay, we don't want them to peak too soon.
Absolutely.
We want to keep it. But this kind of performance tonight, this is what this team is capable of, and this is only going to motivate them and help them, you know, stay on this high level, work, you know, each week in and out. The freshmen are now into the third week. It's like, oh, we got to go back into the gym and train again. We don't get any time off. No, it's week after week after week. And this is what you can do. We told you you were going to be good, but it was going to take a lot of work.
Absolutely.
And it took a lot of work this week with them after that performance at Arkansas to turn it around, and I think the crowd really helped motivate them tonight, and that's what's the great thing about the Coleman Coliseum crowd tonight.
Awesome.
13,778. If you weren't in here tonight, shame on you. Let's get back here in 2 weeks to support this Crimson Tide as they come in with, I think we compete against Auburn,
yep,
first week in February. So we need to pack this house up, because this is the kind of gymnastics that this team is capable of. Last week, an anomaly on the balance beam. Three come off. Tonight, nobody comes off anything, and we see the score, 197.400.
Of course, we have that meet 2 weeks from now, February 6th at 7 p.m. versus the Auburn Tigers. Also, a programming note, tomorrow night, Alabama takes on Auburn in basketball, and the only place to listen to the home call of the game is right here on 90.7 FM, the Capstone. I believe Cam 2 is going to have the call of that game, so you want to tune in there. Here comes Coach Dana Duckworth. She's ready to join us. I give her a high five before she comes on.
We have an excited coach talking.
Hey,
to
Dana,
the nation.
How do you feel to knock off the number one team in the nation?
You know what? I'm just proud of our ladies. You know,
Yeah.
There were so many amazing things. First of all, the crowd. 13,700-something crowd. Loved having the military over there. It was such a special night, just honoring, you know, the men and the women that serve our country by being able to do our sport. How cool was that?
Before Lisa asks you the real intelligent gymnastics question, I have to ask you about the beam. What did you do this week in practice to just adjust? Because last week, we all know the disappointment, three gymnasts fell. This week, absolute nails on that balance beam.
We just worked on mental toughness, focusing on one moment at a time. And no matter what happened, the next second was most important. That's what we did. And these ladies, it was so atypical last week. I knew they could do this. And now we've got to continue to grow on it. We still have room for improvement on that event. We certainly do. But, I mean, so many amazing things tonight.
Okay, so let's look at it. Let's break it down rotation by rotation. Keely Beneer starts the team off with a really great vault. That's 2 weeks in a row that she's really come through for y'all. Let's talk about the vault and Kayla Williams and the balk on that, because that was interesting and how she recovered from that.
Well, what people may not know is that as long as you don't run down and touch the board, then you can do it again. You get another try. Her steps are really off, and so she made a good call. She could have gotten hurt if she was going to enter the board the wrong way. So to be able to have Caitlin Clark come in there with a 9.975 and start us off with a 49.5 on ball, set the tone for the night.
Going to uneven bars, we saw the real conservative judging on uneven bars of Florida, and then it continued with Alabama. You and Coach Ryan Rochella have talked about that to us during the fall. That's the kind of judging you like to see. You really want to see the critique, the criticism, so that y'all can go back in and train. Talk about that judging tonight on bars.
Well, when you don't hit handstands, it's a deduction. And a lot of times I don't necessarily know if they take it. And we need to know. We need to know where our deductions. Because when we go up against the best, when there's six teams on the floor, you want to know what you need to do to be great. So proud, though, of Lauren's anchoring the 9-9, sticking that dismount the way she did. But everyone just hitting and going aggressive. That's what was so awesome about bars.
You go to the balance beam. We all know the trouble last week. Three gymnasts come off tonight. Did you expect that just the sheer confidence that this team displayed on balance beam tonight?
Honestly, I did. We changed the lineup. We started off with Kayla Williams. You know, I kept breathing in. I am confident beyond reason. If we can just continue to believe in what we're capable of, then Beam will take care of itself.
You moved Kayla from the anchor position to the start-off position. In her first 2 years at Alabama, she was in that lead-off position. Is she more comfortable there for y'all?
Well, I think time will tell. I think one competition is, you know, not enough to know, but I believe that it's a good start.
We go to the floor exercise. The crowd obviously going nuts over all these floor exercise routines. But again, we weren't seeing the crowd, you know, expected 10s, 10s, 10s because the performance was so great. But we know there were some errors in there. It wasn't as perfect. You know you've got room to improve, but what a night to finish it on the floor exercise.
It really was. It was not perfect. We certainly have room for improvement. But you know what? The fans lifted us up.
Mm-hmm.
I cannot say enough about our students. Our students rock, and the way they stand up and they get involved, it makes the world a difference. And that's why we need people to keep on coming and supporting, because it's so amazing. You know, we had some different passes that struggled, but we also had a new double layout out there with Lauren Beers. I thought Caitlin Clark's routine was meticulous. Her landings were controlled. That's what we wanted. We wanted mild to moderate expression, controlled landing, and a great leap. And I think that's exactly what we did.
So the last question for you here. Thank you for joining us, too. You're listening to 94.7 Up the Cap. So quickly, just talk to the senior leadership this week, how they took over, especially on the balance beam.
It was just one routine at a time, everyone getting in their energy zone, making a big difference.
The Bama bubble, as we call it.
The Bama bubble. Okay. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, Coach Dana Duckworth, of course, you're going to have to join us February 6th, 7 o'clock against Auburn, and we are now lucky enough to be joined by Asia Sims, who was absolutely phenomenal tonight. Asia, what does it mean to you to beat a team like the Florida Gators?
Talk about this crowd tonight, 13,000 come in to really help support you behind the Crimson Tide. We know the team, the nation knew y'all struggled on the road last week at Arkansas. Having this many people come out to really get y'all back on track, how did that feel?
It felt great. We love our fans so much. We're so glad we had this turnout. And just having all those fans behind us is so much.
Asia, the team started out really solid on the vault. Then we go to the uneven bars. We're seeing both teams not get super high scores on that, doing good routines. But we talked to Coach Dana Duckworth. That's the kind of judging she wants to see, the super critique, so that y'all can go in and really work on stuff. How did you feel with your ball routine tonight?
Oh, definitely. I agree. Like, just how
You've got a very difficult ball routine, but what did it mean to you last week to see two teammates up their difficulty on their dismounts, Carly Sims last week and also Katie Bailey throwing the more difficult dismounts and hitting them?
I was so excited and happy for my team. Whenever a teammate can upgrade their whole team and just make our team better, that's just better for everyone, so I was so excited.
Okay, two great weeks of performances on balance team for you, but let's talk about the floor exercise because we know you have a little bit more wiggle room to upgrade your difficulty. Talk to the fans about that, what we're going to see down the road from Asia to Mason.
Oh, yeah, I definitely want to upgrade my first pass.
Good luck. Keep at it, Asia. We'll see you next week on the road to Kentucky.
Asia Shims, a model of consistency, competed in three events today, 9.850 on all three. Asia, thanks for joining us here on the Capstone. And now we're going to be joined by senior All-American captain. My goodness, what an unbelievable vault you had today. And we are joined by Caitlin Clark. Caitlin, highest score of the evening, 9.975. Don't lie to anybody at home. Did you think you had a 10 at one point?
You know, the scores really aren't that important to me. The fact that I could just go out there and give my team the best ball that I could possibly do was just rewarding in itself. And the high scores are just, you know, icing on the cake.
What does it mean for you and your team to knock off the number one Florida Gators?
I mean, it's a really good accomplishment. We've been working really hard, especially coming back from that struggle last week on beam. I was really proud of how we handled the pressure and how we were able to just stay calm and just stay in our one team.
Caitlin, Coach complimented you on, you might not have been able to hear her, but she said that was your best floor exercise, your execution on all of your leaps, plus your tumbling was the best you put out there this season. Talk to us about that floor exercise. You know, you haven't competed on the floor for the team for 3 years consistently. You did it a couple of times on the road, one at Missouri, but what does it mean to you to be able to not only train floor this year as a senior gymnast, and to do extremely difficult floor routines, and we know you've still got something else to add to your floor exercise.
Yeah, it's really rewarding because I've really been training floor since I got here, but injuries have kept me off the event. And so to be able to be healthy enough to compete for my team is just really rewarding. And Dana's really been working with me on how to compete floor because I get really excited still. Because I don't have that experience yet, and I think today just shows how much work we've put into it.
What the Crimson Tide fans know you for is your uneven ball routine. We haven't seen you this season yet. We know you've got some elbow issues. When will we see you on the uneven bars?
Well, I just started doing full bar routines without a spot on my bail. So we thought maybe tonight, but we still want to hold off a little bit longer because the end game is postseason and being able to put our best foot forward and our best lineup during that season. So we thought it was the best just to keep me off bars for today.
Caitlin, as a senior leader of this team, talk about how not getting too high and not getting too low last week as a disappointing loss in Arkansas. Tonight, you knock off the number one team in the nation. How do you find that happy medium as a leader of this team?
You know, really, we've been working on it all week. One thing that we've discussed as a team is our energy, and so we've been practicing it in the gym, and we just came out here and wanted to keep it just like practice, and that's exactly what we did tonight.
Absolutely. Looking forward to seeing you next week in Lexington. Ladies and gentlemen, that was Caitlin Clark joining us here on the Alabama Gymnastics Radio Network, 90.7 FM, the Capstone. Now we're going to throw it over to the third member of our broadcasting team, live blogger Jan Davis. Jan, what did you see tonight from our Crimson Tide?
You know, the surprising thing about coming in late tonight, traffic and everything, and late at work, was I just was very relaxed. You know, you go into a meet like this knowing that both teams are more than capable of running away with the victory. And I think I felt relaxed, and I really sensed that about this team. And that was the key. They went in very focused, very relaxed, and I think they really got what the coach was telling them in practice is that you cannot perform at your top level if you are tight. They learned that from last week, and they wanted them to be challenged this week. If you don't want to lose to Florida, then you've got to relax and do your routine. And that's what we saw tonight. And they did not throw full difficulty on floor.
Yep.
If you notice, Alabama, they saw where the scores were heading, and they knew that they could cut back a little bit, get a little conservative, go with a maybe safer double pike, But if it was where both teams are really one back-to-back, really cranking it, I think you would have seen a little bit more difficulty from them on the floor tonight, but they didn't have to.
We talked about with Coach, too, the judging tonight I thought was very fair, very honest.
Especially on the bars.
Yeah, and the bars, and she talked about that, how she really likes to see the critique of, you know, the super critique of these routines. If you don't hit your handstand, that's what they need to know and to, you know, deduct for them.
And they were also, I think, taking off for the pike bodies on the swing back down and also in the transition move. And that does need to be taken off because when you break that form and you're not as smooth throughout the routine, it's noticeable. So I think they were, the judges deserve kudos for doing that. I think there was also, they were really looking for the routines to define themselves with the dismount. There weren't very many stuck dismounts tonight.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
On the balance beam, I think Alabama was probably their very best. And the score stayed appropriate by the judges for both teams. There was no really fancy scoring. You had to do a perfect routine basically from start to finish and stick your landing. That was good to see as well. The only place that I had a little concern was the vault. I felt like some of the vaults for both teams were a little inflated with scores, but the crowd was getting into it very excited, with the exception of Peter Hunter, an absolutely gorgeous vault. But so is
she's phenomenal.
Yeah, but so is Caitlin's. Mm-hmm. And Alex McMurtry was super distant, just off center a little bit. I thought that one was just a tiny bit overscored, but overall, you saw that the best vaulters got the highest scores.
Right, absolutely. They separated themselves from the rest. Now, we go to floor exercise, the final. Of course, that's where the crowd really gets into it. Carly Sims, 3 weeks in a row.
I think the thing where they took off for her was, you were mentioning a little bit about the late series, but really, if you notice that double layout, she actually went straight up and down. Even though she landed it smoothly, it did not have quite as much amplitude and distance as we saw last week and the week before when she scored higher.
And we saw a couple of little glitches in the middle tumbling passes, the front tumbling passes, from both some Florida gymnasts and Alabama.
And it's amazing that Florida was not checked a little bit on one of the routines because it looked like she was going to do another element, like a punch front out of that, and she did a barani out of it, but she had a little bit of more combination with a leap out of it as well, so I think they went ahead and didn't cut her as much. But yes, I think with Lauren especially, Lauren usually does a full twist out of that, which is much more difficult, and we will be seeing her add more difficulty down the road.
Absolutely. We're going to take a quick break here on 90.7 FM The Capstone. When we come back, we're going to wrap it up and look forward to next week in Lexington, Kentucky, when the Alabama Crimson Tide take on the Wildcats. Stick with us. We're going to be right back.
Your exclusive home for Alabama gymnastics is right here, 90.7 The Capstone.
90.7. We'll be right back.
You're listening to the best sports staff in the country, right here on 90.7 The Capstone.
Welcome back to Coleman Coliseum here in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, as the 7th-ranked Alabama Crimson Tide, no doubt, are going to be headed up that leaderboard because they just upset the number one-ranked team in the nation, and that is the Florida Gators of a score. I'm going to scroll down on my computer here. The final score, Alabama 197.400 to Florida's 196.800. Lisa, Jan, please come talk to me. Who is the competitor of the night for both teams?
I think we look at all-around. They called on Katie Bailey to return to the all-around lineup. She took the last week the floor exercise off for resting, and Lauren Beers also last week.
Yep.
So both of them returned to the all-around lineup. Phenomenal performances from both of them. 39.5 for Lauren Beers. She got second tonight. 39.45 for Katie Bailey, and Keisha Hunter of Florida won with a 39.550. So, you know, all gymnasts tonight, those three in the all-around, just had spectacular performances from start to finish.
I wouldn't be surprised if Keisha Hunter was winning an individual national championship. She is absolutely phenomenal.
Well, you don't know this, but we're educating you still. Keisha was not only, I believe, the all-around winner as a freshman at NCAA's. So we'll have to double-check.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
She was.
She also won the Honda Award as a freshman.
Yep. And Kim Jacob won that as well, right?
And then Bridget Sloan won it the next year.
She's injured today. That's a big loss for Florida.
Exactly. And I think if Bridget had been out there, you would have seen the score definitely closer. But again, you know, she can only do four routines.
Absolutely. It's hard to make up an entire point.
Right, exactly. But I think both teams really did well tonight. I like the confidence now that's coming from the junior class. Carly Sims and Lauren, it's their time to shine. And the more that Carly has success on the floor, and we'll probably see her back in the bars and maybe even in the vault, you can see the quality depth that Alabama is developing. They must have this going into the middle and end of the season and in the postseason. So there's a whole lot more great gymnastics down the road. You haven't even seen the more difficult vaults from this team, and certainly you haven't seen them put up 6 each tumbling past floor routines yet.
As we wrap it up here in Coleman Coliseum, we look forward to next week in Lexington, Kentucky, when the Tide go on to take on the Wildcats. That's going to be a 7 p.m. start. The only place you can listen to that meet is right here on 90.7 The Capstone. We will be traveling there. What are we looking forward to seeing there, the 14th-ranked Wildcats?
14th-ranked, one of their highest rankings in a long time, and second-year coach Tim
Garrison,
forgive me, I'm just too excited about this victory tonight, has them going in the right direction. Their strengths are vault and floor, and they're very solid on balancing, too. The last 2 weeks' performances, they've been bringing in really good scores for the Kentucky Wildcats.
Right. The thing Alabama will need to be careful about going up to Kentucky is that tends to be a fairly tight scoring arena.
Yep.
Yeah.
So Alabama
can take what they last week.
Right.
Yeah.
Alabama can take what they learned hopefully last week and just finish the deal. If they go up there and do what they did not only tonight, but what they were already doing last week against Arkansas, you will probably see a 197 plus score.
Wow.
As long as they stay focused.
And Coach Brian Rochelle told us you only have a small amount of road scores to count, and each one is very important. So that's why they were a little disappointed in that one last week. You know the reason for it, but those road scores are very precious, so you want to do your absolute best on the road.
Absolutely.
Because those count in the RQS and rankings.
Again, tonight, as we look back at it, the visiting Florida Gators, they were number one. They're not going to be number one next week. But
maybe, they're still averaging.
196.800 to Alabama's 197.400. For Jan Davis and Lisa Davis, I'm Johnny Condon. Roll, Tide, roll. You're listening to The Capstone.